Welcome back to the Pen Nook. For this video, I'm going to be doing something pretty fun. It's something I've wanted to do for the past few weeks, and I'm finally getting around to it. And I'm going to be showing you my turquoise pen collection. It's not very extensive. It's basically made up of four pen models that kind of vary in shades. and when I say turquoise, it's anything that goes from mint to a darker teal. But I figured turquoise was a good term to kind of describe the color overall that we'll be going over today, and turquoise is my favorite color, hence why I have so many pens that are in that shade, or that are in that shade range, I should say. If you can't tell, my nail color happens to be turquoise. This wasn't planned, it just turns out that this was the color on my nails for today's video, so anyways, it just goes to show how much I love turquoise. And yeah, we'll just get into it. So the first pen that I ever received that was kind of in the, you know, the mint turquoise shade is this Caveco Sport in mint that was given to me by Frank a few Christmases ago. And it's an extra fine nib, but it actually kind of writes like a fine. And I don't know if it's because I've broken the nib in, so it's smoother, has kind of a thicker line than you would expect for an extra fine, or I just got lucky with this one and it turns out it's a very good nib, but it's super smooth. I use this one a lot during my bachelor degree for any note taking pretty much. And yeah, so this is the first Caveco that I ever received also, and it kind of sent me into the spiral of collecting a few Cavecos myself. Yes, I love this pen, and it was the first ever Caveco gifted to me. Next up is another Caveco. This one is a limited edition. I believe it's from Taiwan, from 2019, or anyway, a few years back. 2019 is the year I purchased it. I actually bought this one probably at least double the price of the mint or any regular Caveco Sport, just because I fell in love with the color. Funny story about this is I've been looking online and I was like, oh, there's no way there isn't a turquoise Caveco out there. So I was searching and then I came up on a picture on Google and I saw this one and I was like, what? Where is this one? You know, where can I find this Caveco? Because I haven't seen it on any of the typical sites I usually shop on. And yeah, so it was a Taiwan exclusive. No wonder I hadn't really come across it before. And I was lucky enough to get one on Amazon before the prices really went way up. And I love this one. I think it's my favorite. I wonder why. Turquoise, I think, is the perfect shade, in my opinion. And this one is in a fine nib. And in comparison to my mint Caveco, this one is actually a lot finer, which is funny. But I guess Caveco nibs are kind of iffy in the sense that, you know, you never know exactly how thick the line will be. I've never had a bad nib, that's not what I'm saying, but I feel like the thicknesses kind of vary. Even if you think you're going to get a fine, sometimes it actually ends up being finer than an extra fine, which is, anyways, my case. I don't know if any of you have also had that experience, but I don't mind having a nib that's finer. It's kind of scratchy, but I just love the color, so eventually I might be able to swap the nib out if really it bothers me, but right now it's no issue. I love this pen, and I'm very happy I got it. The next pen is the Lamy Safari. This is also one of the limited editions from 2019, and it's in the blue macaroon. I love the color of this pen, but I don't actually grab it as much as I do other turquoise pens, so this is maybe a pen that I'll eventually end up selling. I'm keeping a hold of it for now, but we'll see what I end up doing with it. What I love about this is the accents. So I love that on the finial and where the barrel and the grip are screwed together, there's this darker shade of mint. I thought these are really pretty accents. And the nib I have on here is actually one that Frank had gotten, I believe, from, was it eBay? I don't remember, but you know, these cheaper nibs that you can get just to kind of add a bit of spice onto the pen, if you will. I don't love this nib though. It kind of it doesn't go on the feed very well. There's a space that you maybe can't see. It's a cool color, but it's an extra fine too, and I tend to not like fine nibs as much as I do, let's say, medium or broad nibs. So I mean, this is an experiment and it looks good on the pen, but the experience writing with it isn't as joyful as I would have hoped, so I don't find myself grabbing this one as much as the other pens that I'll show you in a second. So we'll see. This is a nice collector's item, but maybe one day I'll end up getting rid of this one to be able to buy something else, but for now it sits in my collection. The next one is a pen that I am heartbroken about, because this was actually a gift from my grandparents as a graduation gift. So it's a Pilot Custom 74 in teal. It's a beautiful pen, and pretty much my most expensive. And it's in a broad nib. Sad story with this one, I don't know if you can tell on camera, but I had only used it a couple of times before. I was cleaning it out, and I had only this part in my hands, and I ended up dropping it, and so one of the tines is slightly bent. Now luckily there's nothing else, like the feed is kind of misaligned, but I feel like that's something that can be kind of pretty easy to fix once the nib is fixed. But yeah, I still need to get this one fixed. Ugh, I'm so annoyed that I have to drop this one of all pens. Can't switch the nib, so I'll definitely have to look into finding a Nibmeister for this. But I haven't been able to use it for, you know, the past year since I dropped it. And obviously during COVID times, finding a Nibmeister is maybe not the easiest thing. But anyways, I will eventually do that. hopefully sooner rather than later, because this pen is really beautiful and it was super juicy. I did have an issue though with the flow, so at least this will give me a chance to kind of just see if it was a feed issue or maybe just the nib itself was had a problem, and now this is just gonna give me the opportunity to just fix it and then be able to fully enjoy it. So we'll see with that. Definitely keeping this one though, but I'm just sad I haven't been able to fully use it. So hopefully I get that one fixed soon. The next one up is my Twisby Eco Turquoise. Now this is my favorite Twisby Eco, because I mean, if you're a turquoise lover like me, it's impossible to go to not love this pen. It's a beautiful color, it's super vibrant, and I love Twisby Ecos, so can't go wrong with either. This is a fine nib. Well, you can't really see the F there, but it's a fine nib. I probably would have chosen a thicker nib size, but I ended up purchasing this from a Japanese seller. Sorry, I'm fumbling with my words today. I think it's too much caffeine. And yeah, so I had actually already been into fountain pens when this came out in 2017, but for some reason the Eco didn't call to me at that time, and I'm so mad at myself because I paid probably like double the price for this Eco. But then, you know, a few years into collecting, I'd ended up getting the yellow-green Eco, and I was like, I have been missing out because these pens are great. And so for a few months, I had been on the search for the Twisby Eco Turquoise, which seemed to be unavailable everywhere that I looked, until I came upon this Japanese seller. I think it's like an Amazon version of Japan, basically. Or a Japanese version of Amazon. Wow, sorry. I don't remember what it's called, the site that I got this from, but anyways, it was a few years back, and I'm just so happy I was able to find this one because it really is one of my favorite pens, and it's still pretty much unavailable everywhere from what I've been able to see. So I got really lucky with this one. Next up is the Twisby Eco Tea in Mint. This was a gift from my brother last Christmas, and I mean, it's very similar to the other mint pens that I have, but this one does seem, the Twisby Eco Tea does seem to be a bit bluer, if that makes sense, than the other two. The Kaweco Mint always almost looks a bit whitish compared to the others. But yeah, so I guess it's similar, but not quite the same color as the other two pens. And I love this pen. It's a medium nib. The only problem, this is probably the only Twisby Eco nib that I've had slight issues with. I don't know if something is misaligned in the feed or in the tines. It doesn't seem like anything is really wrong with it. Maybe it's just flow issues. So it does skip here and there, but nothing too intense to the point where I don't want to use it. I might kind of venture out into trying to fix it myself eventually, depending on what the issue is. So I haven't grabbed this pen as much because of that, but still a good pen. And Twisby Ecos, I mean, ooh, my god, you can never go wrong with these. The last pen that I'm going to show you is the Lamy Safari Aquamarine. So this was the special edition for 2020. This is probably the perfect shade of turquoise. I think these three are probably my favorite shades. This one is a lot darker than the other two, but this is probably one of the perfect shades of turquoise, let's put it that way. I have this one in a medium nib. This is part of Frank's birthday gift from last year. And I don't think I need any other Lamy Safari after having this one. I do have the mango also that I really love. But those two paired together, I think I'm set for this as far as safaris go. And I love the fact that this pen is pretty much unicolor other than the nib. Everything is in the same aquamarine turquoise, and it's just very pretty. It really stands out, and it kind of matches my nail polish. Probably the one that matches my polish the most. Fun fact. I don't think you can go wrong with a safari either. So this is my full collection. And like I said, I think my favorites are going to be probably the Blue Lagoon Kaweco Sport, the Twisby Eco Turquoise. I can't say if it would be the Lamy Safari Aquamarine or, I mean, the Pilot Custom 74 that I haven't been able to use as much. But anyways, these are my turquoise, mint, teal pens that I love. It might not seem like much, only 7 of them, but out of a collection that is only made up of 19 pens right now, 7 is a lot to have in a similar color, but I just love this color so much, and I mean, the collection is full for now for turquoise pens, but who knows what pens will come out in the next few years. It'll possibly grow. But yeah, let me know if you have any of these pens, if any of these pens you've been looking for or you've been eyeing and that this video has potentially convinced you to buy. I'd be interested to know that. Thanks for watching, and please like and subscribe if you like this video. Let me know in the comments below if you have any video content that you'd really love to see. And yeah, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time on the Pen Nook. Bye!